I'm Dan, Chief Instructor at DW Aviation, and today I want to talk about advanced scenario training. DW Aviation is a boutique flight training business in Phoenix, Arizona, and we provide not just pilot training, Part 61, like you would find at other places, but we provide more niche services as well. So for private pilots, people who own their own aircraft and need some cross-training or want to focus and hone in on a specific goal or objective, that's definitely something that we can help with. We provide online ground school, and one of the things that we provide is advanced scenario training. So this is training for private pilots, instrument pilots, commercial pilots, CFIs, doesn't matter because at the end of the day, we're all flying airplanes. So it's an advanced scenario, basically. So a scenario that you wouldn't necessarily find on your normal day-to-day flight profile. So, you know, when you think about the last time you did a rejected takeoff, most people have never done a rejected takeoff, an aborted takeoff. You get all the way through your private pilot training and you never actually have to do one. It's something that I do with all my students, and that's what we're going to be looking at today. We also do advanced scenarios of landing on dirt strips, on how to take off on a dirt strip. It's something that you might do as a private pilot for fun if you just have, you know, if you buy a ranch house and you've got a dirt or a grass strip, it's a real soft field landing or takeoff. So doing those for real and seeing what that's like in the actual airplane is extremely helpful. And that also is beneficial because if you do unfortunately have a power off landing at some point in your career off field, you need to know how the airplane is going to perform. But today we're going to talk about an aborted takeoff. This is a student of mine who I've trained for years at different levels of his pilot training, and now he's a triple rated instructor, ground instructor, advanced ground instructor as well. I like to throw scenarios, especially at my CFI friends. When we're flying around for fun, I always love to do something that they're not expecting to see how they handle it, obviously in a safe manner, but complacency is what will get people injured or killed, and you don't want that in aviation. So, to avoid being complacent, just realize that these advanced scenarios are not so out of the ordinary that they could never happen to you. They are uncommon, however, they could still happen on every flight. So that's kind of what we were looking at for this aborted takeoff scenario. So in this scenario, I called air traffic control ahead of time and I told them what I was planning, but the student had no idea. He had no idea that we were getting an aborted takeoff. He thought we were taking off from that airport, flying up to Payson, going to Sedona and coming back. I had told him we were doing some advanced scenario training, but I did not tell him what that was. You'll see in the video, he assumed that it was in the air that we were gonna do something, but alas, it was not. So in this video clip, what you're gonna see is basically we get our takeoff clearance. I had coordinated again with air traffic control before this, so they knew that we were aborting the takeoff.
4 Delta 10, 22 left, ready for departure.
This is 977 4 Falcon Tower, runway 22 left, clear for takeoff.
Left clear for takeoff, 774. Alright, I've got those strobe lights on. And final's clear. Perfect. And verify 22 left.
81 AJ arrival with information. Julia, we like to request one touch and go and then a full stop turn main.
2781 left base runway 22 left.
Hey, you got a right crosswind. Left crosswind here, it shifts at midway.
Yep.
81.
And heading matches runway.
Fox Tower Skyhawk 2050.
And power set.
2 left, ready for departure.
Instruments in the green. Airspeed's alive.
And abort, abort, abort. Engines out.
All right. And abort, abort, abort. 774.
9774, roger.
All right.
Cancel takeoff clearance. Left turn, one able. Runway, you going back to the ramp there? You going back up again?
Right here. 774, we'll take a full stop taxi back.
Let's take a look at that again and then we'll break down what happened. But I want you to look at his hand on the throttle. When I say abort, 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 his hand goes from being full throttle to pulling that back to idle. And it took less than 2 seconds. And then he got on the radio and he did everything perfectly. So again, he aviated, navigated, communicated. And that's perfect. That's what we train for. And this could have been a real scenario. You heard me say abort, 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 the engine's out. And he didn't ask questions, which is what a lot of people do. He just reacted, did that memory item, did exactly what he's trained to do. And it's one of the best reaction times you could have. So let's take a look at that clip one more time.
Power set.
2-2 left, ready for departure.
Instruments in the green. Airspeed's alive.
And abort, abort, abort. Engine's out.
All right. And abort, 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 774.
9774, roger.
All right. That was it. That was the scenario I wanted to throw at you, because like I said, it can happen every flight, and it's that quick. Normally, the reaction time is at least 1,000 feet, so good job.
No, I thought we were going to do something like up in the air or something with like Phoenix departure or something like that. Some sort of scenario like up in the air.
Yep, that's all I had for you.
Cool.
You never have to continue a takeoff. You can always abort a takeoff if there's a safety or a concern about the flight. You do have to land, however. So if you're having a problem, it's better to keep that problem on the ground. Even if you're on the takeoff roll and you're almost at your rotation speed, just abort the takeoff, do what you train to do, and this is why we have a pre-departure brief. So that being said, everything he did here was perfect. One thing that students do a lot, and before I solo any student, we do at least one abort a takeoff for real, where they don't know that it's coming. What tends to happen, I think you heard me say it in the video, but what tends to happen is that people will take almost 1,000 feet of runway or more, which is a few seconds going that airspeed, because they will question things. There's this kind of bystander effect of, you know, you hear me say something and then you're arguing with the instructor and you're like, oh wait, I don't see anything wrong with the engine. What do you mean abort? And by the time you have that conversation, now you're 1,000 feet down the runway. Whatever the scenario is, it's always important to be on top of things, to be well-trained and proficient, as well as current with everything else. So that's the benefit of advanced scenario training. We can certainly help you with that here at DW Aviation. Just go to dwaviation.us and you can get in touch with us there. Send a request in what you want to do specifically. We can train in your airplane, we can train you in our airplanes, and we can make you a safer and more proficient pilot. Thanks for watching.